squeeze in tight. There is no degree of separation between us and Francesco Michelin. Francesca Milian, Italy's Eurovision 2016 singer, was the winner of X Factor Italia. She has an amazing voice and a beautiful personality. You guys, we've had the chance to meet her a few times, and she is pure sunshine, and she's bringing a well-produced song with a catchy melody. Clearly, I'm showing you how positive I am. How do you feel about it?
I like the song. I like Francesca. I think that it's probably better, I thought, just in the pure Italian version, which I much preferred to this kind of weird shoehorned in English, which doesn't work as well as, say, France's Amir, where they worked the English and French in very well together from the start. All that being said, it is a good effort. It's not as good as Il Volo. It's probably not one of my favourite Italian songs since they've come back, but it is. It's a genuine... It's Italy. You expect a genuinely good song from them.
See, no, I disagree. I feel like this is better than Il Volo because this is mainstream and accessible. And Il Volo smashed the televote on a popular song. I feel like Francesca can nail the jewelry, she can do televotes. Like, I think Italy might have it sewn up this year in a year where there's not really a clear front runner. I think this is, like, very mainstream. It's very cool. And this is the thing. Italian, it could be really old-fashioned and staged. I mean, like, Sanremo is not the most modern of formats. But she has a very cool, icy-sounding song, and I actually disagree, Chris. I think the English works perfectly. It's very flawless, it's very elegant, and, like, she's 17, right? She's very young, and this is the bomb.
I think adding the English, actually, yeah, to second what Angus says, gives it that universality. It gives it, it just broadens it, its appeal. And, you know, it's a very sweet melody, it plods along beautifully, and then she adds the English, there's no degree of separation, kind of giving it added meaning. So, for me, props up to that. In a recent interview with Francesca, which I think William interviewed her, she said...
Love you, girl! Hi!
She says that lava just pours out of her. She's like a volcano waiting to erupt. And you know what? When I hear no degree of separation, I just feel that sort of release. Do you know what I mean? Like, yeah. You know, it's just like... It's really, this song is super, super strong. And Il Volo last year, I'm sorry, that's so last year. Mm. And I think that this is a really strong effort. I also like her for the fact that she wasn't the first choice for Italy, but she jumped on it with open arms, saying, you know what, this is an opportunity I'm not going to miss, and this is the sort of attitude that we welcome at Eurovision.
Hey, I'm Sophie.
You know what? She wasn't the first choice, but she was the right choice.
Yeah!
This song is so much stronger. She is such a sweet girl. The song has a sweetness, yet it's still pop. It's contemporary, and yet it somehow feels classic. This is the kind of song I would play while making love in a field of flowers with the sun shining on my naked body. It makes you so comfortable. She's got a beautiful voice that fits this type of music perfectly. I think in terms of the language, I'm Team Chris on this one. I don't think the English is necessary, but it doesn't detract, so it's fine. I mean, we're ultimately where we started, a great song. I'm feeling good about her. You know, the bookies have not been behind this, you know, particularly strongly, but I'm not gonna factor that in. I think this is a great effort, and again, Italy, they bring their A game to Eurovision. The staging will be good. We've seen so far the live performances vocally. She's on point.
And the bookies don't have a crystal ball. You know, a lot of what they review is similar to what we do with the WeWe jury, where we kind of gauge our first reactions. Really, the determining factor is the night. You know, the jury finals. Yes. That's really what determines it.
In any event, Chris, let's go around and give our scores out of 10 with a justification.
So I gave this song a 7.5, and retrospectively, I think I might actually lower that a little bit if I could, but I can't. Our scores were locked in. There's just something that makes me feel like it's just missing that killer thing to win Eurovision. And I wonder if it's slightly actually Francesca herself, just because I've never, in every performance I've seen of it, there's just that little bit of connection that I'm kind of missing with it. And maybe that's just me. Maybe it hasn't clicked yet, but that's my kind of issue with it.
It is just Chris. I give this an 8.5. This is fabulous. I think Italy are on point. And I think, like, 2011, they were a complete dark horse, no derated madness of love. And I think Nessun Grado di Separazione, same appeal. Like, this could win. This could win the whole shebang. I'm totally on board.
So I don't think this is the winner of Eurovision 2016, but I do think this is a beautiful song. I think for me, you know, my score was given 3 weeks ago before the live performances, so I would give this a higher score now if I could, but we have to stick with our scores for averaging purposes. What I'm trying to say is this. The song doesn't have enough mountain and valley for me. It's very hill and trough, which is fine. There's space for that in music and in this contest. But I think to win Eurovision, you do need a bit more of that Moliva, you know, that kind of pow moment. And this is more sweet and not plodding. That's the wrong word. It's sweet and flowing, but it's not like the roar.
It tries to use the English bit as that pow moment, and I don't think that connects.
But in any event, my score is a 6, but that is given with love and with the knowledge that I'd rate this much higher based on the live version.
Ernst & Young, they're tough. We can't change our scores. I'm giving this a 6.5. And just to close my narrative, I'd like to thank Italy for justifying its position year after year as being an automatic qualifier. It's not relying on that status. It brings the A game forward.
And
they've done so again this year.
When you are invited to the party and put in the VIP line, you need to bring a dish. You need to bring some champagne for your host. And Italy does it every year. They bring the appetizer, the main course, and the dessert.
They are bringing that buffalo mozzarella.
Yes, with the basil on the side. In any event, there are 40 WeWe jurors all around the world, ranging in age from 14 to 65 in more than 25 countries. And the overall average across all these random crazies is 7.47. Very good. Excellent score, honestly. That's what we think. What do you think? Is there a degree of separation between you and Francesca? Let us know here on WeWe Blogs.
And give us a thumbs up if you like the video.
And there can be no more degree of separation between us and you, so make sure to hit that subscribe button.
Oh God, William, you kill me every time with this dinner party analogy. Please add your comments. Let us know what you think down below.
Bring something to the party. See you later.
Bye!